Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A new picture of the cosmos is emerging, a vastly different picture than the one astronomers have been painting for over a century, but a picture that was drawn many decades ago by specialists in plasma and the electrical sciences. In this picture, antiquated notions of charge neutrality in space have been erased, replaced with theoretical models which recognize the pervasive conductive medium, or fifth state of matter called plasma, through which electric currents flow throughout the cosmos. For many decades, electric currents were, and in some instances remain, verboten in the space sciences. But with improved instrumentation and ever finer data, cosmic electric currents at all scales are now undeniable. Nevertheless, a strange dilemma is unfolding in astronomy and astrophysics. Scientists attempt to explain electric currents in space through theoretical models in which electricity does not cause anything. But as we will see, electric currents in space are not just a curious byproduct of gravitational and magnetic phenomena. From the electric universe perspective, the measurement of electric currents in space is the inevitable recognition of the electrical circuitry that connects celestial bodies across interplanetary, interstellar, and intergalactic space. It's essential to remember that electric currents are only visible when they meet regions of dust and gas, where one sees the unmistakable filamentary structure of electrified plasma, as in the vast star-forming networks in our own Milky Way. Measuring the strength of cosmic electric currents is, of course, no easy matter for scientists on Earth, and is even vastly more challenging than estimating the strength of cosmic magnetic fields. A good recent example can be found in our own solar system and scientists' investigation of the Saturnian moon Enceladus. As we outlined in a recent space news, prior to the arrival of the Cassini spacecraft at Saturn over a decade ago, planetary scientists had expected Enceladus to be, quote, geologically dead. Instead, they found explosive filamentary jets shooting material at tremendous velocities up to hundreds of kilometers from the moon's surface. Adding to the surprise, the jets were seen at the moon's south pole, the last place they expected such activity. As reported by space.com in 2005, the finding flipped everything scientists knew about Enceladus on its head, because what should have been a dead moon appeared to be geologically active, and what was supposed to be the moon's coldest region turned out to be its warmest. Since their discovery, scientists have interpreted the features as so-called ice geysers, which they view as a form of cryovolcanism, probably resulting from Saturn's gravitational forces producing tidal heating within the moon. In 2008, Cassini's plasma spectrometer discovered evidence for electrical currents in the plumes of water and dust. In recent years, a number of papers have been written on the presence of negatively charged dust grains in the so-called plumes. And now, based on data from the Cassini-Langmuir probe, a new scientific paper is providing evidence that these dust grains have actually, quote, blocked the signal of the powerful electrical currents in the Enceladus jets. For a number of years, standard theory has proposed that electrically neutral water molecules are ejected from the moon's surface, where UV rays from the sun and interactions with plasma in Saturn's magnetosphere strips electrons from water molecules, forming positively charged water ions. In theory, these ions are then free to be, quote, picked up and merge with co-rotating plasma, supposedly generating an electric current. Cassini scientists had estimated the strength of the jet's electric currents based on disturbances to Cassini's magnetometer instrument. But as noted in a summary of the new scientific paper in the Journal of Geophysical Research, when Cassini flew through the icy plume, its instrument sent back vastly different readings. According to the craft's Langmuir probe, which measures particle density, there were enough ions present to generate a current of 10 million amps. The magnetometer indicated a current more than 20 times weaker. The authors provide experimental evidence that ions like those in the Enceladus plume are, quote, attracted and trapped within the sheaths of negatively charged dust grains. They conclude that, quote, Cassini's Langmuir probe is measuring the entire ion population, both free and trapped ions, while the Cassini magnetometer detects the magnetic perturbations associated with pickup currents from the smaller population of free ions, with this distinction possibly reconciling the ongoing debate in the literature on the ion density in the plume. Simply put, the results are anomalous for the standard, quote, pickup ions model. But they are expected if the surface of Enceladus is being etched by electrical discharge machining, as our chief science advisor, Wal Thornhill, has always proposed. Electrical discharge machining works by stripping electrons from high points on a surface. In this process on Enceladus, positive ions generated on the surface are heated by electric discharge and electrostatically attracted to follow the electrons into space. This would, in fact, explain the high loading of positive ions that the Langmuir probe measured. And as we reported in great detail in a recent space news, the notion that the gravitational influences of the gas giants Jupiter and Saturn produces tidal heating in their respective moons, resulting in cryovolcanism, has never been more questionable in light of new discoveries. As we noted, in 2013, scientists reported that the locations of the so-called volcanic plumes on Io are completely incompatible with the moon's internal heat signatures, a finding which, according to lead author Christopher Hamilton, can't be reconciled with any existing solid body tidal heating models. Likewise, on Enceladus, in 2016, scientists were amazed to discover that when the so-called geysers on the moon are producing the most water and dust, the accompanying gas output was anomalously low. As reported by space.com, the researchers expected quite a lot more gas expelled at the far part of Enceladus's orbit to help explain the outpouring of dust, but they found the gas output had bumped up by just 20%, far less than expected. The leader of the study said of the findings, "We had thought the amount of water vapor in the overall plume across the whole south polar area was being strongly affected by tidal forces from Saturn. Instead, we find that the small-scale jets are what's changing." Both scientists' new insights into the strength of the electric currents in the Enceladus plumes and the failure of the tidal heating models to explain discovery are stunning victories for the electrical interpretation of the phenomenon. Of course, given scientists' difficulties in accurately measuring the electric currents at Enceladus, this naturally emphasizes the present technical and observational constraints on quantifying the electromagnetic energies at the vastest cosmic scales. However, as we've reported in many recent episodes, the evidence for cosmic-scale electric currents is being more and more routinely presented in mainstream scientific literature. One of the most spectacular electromagnetic phenomena in space is the many light-years long collimated jets produced at active galactic nuclei. Today, standard astrophysics offers no explanation for the phenomena that does not involve a hypothetical black hole producing tremendous magnetism. However, with increasing regularity, mainstream scientific literature has proposed that the jets are composed of powerful electric currents. From radio astronomers estimating the current in an extragalactic jet, supposedly the equivalent of a trillion bolts of lightning, to more recent scientific papers, which describe a, quote, battery mechanism close to the hypothetical black hole producing electric currents. As a recent paper by Gabuzda et al. States, astrophysical jets are fundamentally electromagnetic structures. Nevertheless, in every case, astrophysicists can only envision colossal gravity producing magnetic fields, which are somehow primary in the creation of the spectacular, quote, cosmic lightning. A recent phys.org report describes new findings that can only confound the standard interpretation of so-called black hole jets. As matter is broken down around a black hole, jets of electrons are launched by the magnetic field from either pole of the black hole at almost the speed of light. Astronomers have long been flummoxed by these jets. But this view is not supported by new research into the magnetic field surrounding a, quote, black hole that is believed to be in our own Milky Way, within a microquasar in the constellation Cygnus. The phys.org report summarizes the findings. The team observed the magnetic field of a black hole within our own galaxy from multiple wavelengths for the first time. They discovered that magnetic fields are much weaker than previously understood, a puzzling finding that calls into question previous models of black hole components. The research shows a deep need for continued studies on some of the most mysterious entities in space. However, the real deep need may be for astrophysicists to finally consider actual theoretical alternatives to the black hole's existence. As stated many times by physicist Wal Thornhill, what these increasingly problematic discoveries highlight is the problem of over-specialization in the sciences. Far removed from the spotlight of popular science, for decades, plasma cosmologists have presented experimental evidence that the spectacular electromagnetic phenomena that space scientists attribute to black holes is in fact a high-density energy storage phenomenon demonstrated in laboratories, called a plasmoid. In several episodes, we have briefly described how a plasmoid is a kind of load in a galactic electrical circuit, concentrating and storing energy. When a plasmoid reaches a threshold density, it will discharge, usually along a galaxy's spin axis, producing the stupendous galactic jets whose electric currents are now increasingly recognized in mainstream scientific literature. All astrophysicists who seek an answer to the mystery of cosmic jets should be acquainted with the experimental research into the plasmoid's applicability to cosmic phenomena. We encourage viewers to consider the landmark research of the scientific pioneer, the late physicist and MIT scientist Winston H. Bostick, whose experimental research on the plasmoid led to the development of the dense plasma focus device. Bostick simulated many astrophysical phenomena through plasma physics experiments, including galaxy formation and spectacular cosmic jets. The jets' collimation over tremendous cosmic distances. The knotted structures seen in many jets. Their nearly light speed velocity. Their emissions of synchrotron radiation. And now the inferred measurements of electric currents in the jets are all the predictable features of a discharging galactic plasmoid. Since the plasmoid's jets are part of a vastly larger electrical circuit, this can also resolve an enduring, intractable problem for astrophysicists, which is the mysterious source of the energy to the most distant parts of the cosmic jets, sometimes over many hundreds of thousands of light years. Occam's razor states, "The simplest explanation is the most likely." Standard astrophysics tells us that electric currents in space are the product of extremely complex and strange gravitational and magnetic processes. The electric universe states that electric currents flow through the conductive medium of plasma, which composes more than 99% of the visible universe. Celestial bodies moving in electrified environments are electromagnetically connected and will discharge electrically when experiencing dramatic voltage spikes. As we see on our own planet in the form of spectacular blue jets, elves, and red sprites above the clouds reaching towards space. Electric currents in space mean only one thing. We live in an electric universe.